This problem is from this data set, right? It's an SPSS. It's all preset for you. So is there a significant difference in annual salaries between the seven schools in the nominal variable named school? So school is our grouping IV, just one IV with seven levels, and the annual salaries is the DV. That makes it a one-way ANOVA because it's only got one IV. We're going to write up the results in APA. We're going to address the assumptions. The big three are normality of the DV, homogeneity, the variance of the groups of the DV, and independence of observation or sampling, and there's no way for us to check that. And we're going to look at the effect size and the power, and we're also going to run a Tukey test. We're going to do this in SPSS, so it's going to go real fast. SPSS has two files. This is your data file, .sav. This is the one that looks like a spreadsheet, right? It's got all the numbers on it. And the data file has two parts. One was the variable view, and that's where you name the variables, and you tell the computer what kind they are, and if they're categorical, these are the different categories, etc., etc. The second SPSS file is your output file. This is where all the charts and graphs and tables and p-values and all the calculation results are shown. So let's get to it. You could do anything in SPSS from either this file or the data file. It doesn't make a difference. Let me show you real quick. But we're going to go to Analyze, General Linear Model, Univariate. The univariate means one DV. So annual salaries is our DV. School is our fixed factor. Remember, factor means categorical variable. And then we're going to go ahead and start picking stuff. Plots, don't care. Post hoc. So the Tukey test is a post hoc test. So you click over the variable. And all of these are post hoc tests. And they should, most of them agree with each other. It's not a big deal. But I prefer Tukey because it does them all at the same time. And I'm going to options. And I do this every time. Okay. Every time I run an ANOVA, this is automatic for me. This is the between group ANOVA and the Tukey test. Remember, you need at least three groups to run a Tukey test. That's why you won't ever run one in like a t-test or something, because they only have two groups. So let's go okay. Okay. Here are the results of your one-way between group ANOVA. So instead of doing it by hand, which in the old days, not too long ago, we would make you do it, but not anymore. So the first box tells you how many in each group. So it looks like you had six per school. There's your means. I always look at the means first. Look at the high one. That's 657. And look at the low one. And that's about, what, 45. So there's roughly 21,000 difference there. I'm pretty sure that's going to be a significant difference. But let's keep going. This says you did not violate the assumption of homogeneity variance, the means test. And here's your money box right here. So your corrected model and the name of your single variable should be identical, and they are. And we got a sig value of 0.351, which means there was no significant difference between the group means. Done, period. Don't mention anything else. And I'm going to go ahead and write it up for you. Here's the write-up. A one-way between group ANOVA indicated that there was no significant difference between the salaries of the seven different schools. So this first number, F, is the six, represents the degrees of freedom for your between group, which is your categorical variable. And the 35 is the degrees of freedom for your error term, also known within group variance. Can't do a lot about that. But your p-value is nowhere near under 0.05. So insignificant ANOVAs are easy to write up because you stop right there. Right? If it's not significant, you really don't care about the effect size because it's going to be, you know, negligible, if that. And no use running a Tukey test because there's no significant difference in there anywhere. We already know that, okay? I forgot to check the assumption of normality. Shame on me. I do that all the time. I run the test first and check the assumptions second, because the output of the test always has several of the assumptions checked in there for you. It's just a lot easier. But we're going to go to Analyze, Descriptives, Explore, get in there. And I just want annual salaries. And all I want to know is, I'll check the histogram. I just want those Kolmogorov or the Shapiro-Wilk tests of normality. And there they are right there. So it did not violate the assumption because the sig value is not less than 0.05. Remember, when testing the assumptions, a small p-value, small sig value, means you violated that assumption. So you don't want anything under 0.05. So this did not violate the assumption of normality. All right, that's it. MGZ, out.